What's going on, everybody? LK here. We spent a lot of time talking about fighting game character archetypes, but today I want to do something a little bit different and start looking at attack archetypes. I wanted to start with the most famous one, the Shoryuken. Usually in the archetype discussion, we're always talking about Shotos, grapplers, zoners, and breaking them down that way. And each of these archetypes attract different types of players. It makes it very easy for new people to pick a playstyle that they like once they understand what the archetypes are, and more experienced players to either gravitate to what they're used to or maybe try something new. The types of attacks sort of fall in the same type of thinking, but instead of course, picking a character, so like this is the type of playstyle I'm gonna have, it's more about, because I understand what type of move this is, I know how to use it at a baseline. Ryu's iconic special move, the Shoryuken, has seen many, many games since its introduction in Street Fighter 2. The move type itself has three important properties. So first, it is invincible immediately. Second, they have a lot of recovery because usually the characters leap into the air. And then last, the actual input, being forward, down, down, forward, or in the community, we'll say 6, 2, 3. Let's look at each of these points before we look at a couple of different types of Shoryukens. So first, we want to look at the invincibility. The invincibility is important because it poses an immediate threat. Just the fact that the move is invincible means the opponent either needs to gamble against it by reading it, or they need to totally restructure their pressure to account for it coming. Things that are normally not challengeable now become risky because of the threat of the Shoryuken. Then, the recovery. So, despite the invincibility, the Shoryuken is a risk. If you miss it, the character is vulnerable for a very long time. You can see here that I have a lot of ways I can hit this Shoryuken. Because of this, I can try to optimize and do a very, very high damage punish that I would not easily get from punishing other special moves. The part about it reaching high in the air so that it has a lot of recovery, this is a traditional thing, but it also kind of depends on the game. So you don't see it so much in games where you have a lot of mobility, but in games with less mobility, it reaching up into the air is a factor because you can use it as an anti-air as well. Good examples here would be, of course, Street Fighter, where the move originated, but in modern games, you can think about games like Grand Blue Fantasy Versus as well. And then last is the input. So special move inputs have always been a gatekeeper for new players, but the Shoryuken has always been an especially difficult one. So half the reason is because how they show the input in games, and the other half is actually doing the input. As I mentioned before, there's a couple of different Shoryuken inputs that they tend to use, but the traditional one is forward, down, or down forward, which is 6-2-3 if you use number notation. The main thing here is, again, there's an emphasis on commitment and risk. So you're not doing any blocking input during this move at all. You're holding forward, down, and down forward. So all forward, all attacking. You're totally committed to not blocking for doing this move. So these three points together give us your typical Shoryuken. It is immediately recognizable, even outside of fighting games. The combination of the immediate invincibility, the recovery, and the input suggests that it's a move designed to be like a high commit, like, oh, I know, or I see you here, so I'm going to pick this. So with that in mind, what type of Shoryukens are there? Now that we have the formula of a Shoryuken built out, how do they tend to change it? So the main direct way they tend to change this is by straight up changing the input. The input matters a lot because it affects the amount of commitment that you're putting into the move. So for example, DBFZ has no traditional DP input. They tend to use quarter circles or down down for reversal. So my good old friend, my favorite character in this game, wink wink nudge nudge, Adult Gohan, he does have a pretty honest input for his DP. His is with 236, so quarter circle forward. So you're able to just do it like this. Having the input as 236 makes it essentially the same as a 6-2-3. In fact, the way I learned how to do DP inputs was to do forward, down, down forward, and then forward. And this is to make sure that I went through to the down forward. It's how I learned it, and it's also how I recommend new people to learn it. Anyway, we're going to be looking at three other types of DPs. There are more than these three types I'm going to discuss. In fact, four other characters on the screen, Blue Gogeta, SSJ Vegeta, Cooler, and Beerus, all have quarter circle back, so 2 and 4 DPs. But outside of the three I'm going to talk about now, anything outside of this is usually pretty uncommon slash rare. So I would like to look at the Flash Kick, the 2-2 down-down reversal, and the Button reversal. If we think of the Shoryuken as the meterless invincible reversal, then the next one should also be from the same game, Street Fighter 2, right? So we want to talk about the Flash Kick. So the Flash Kick is incredibly strong input-wise. So while simple, it still intimidates new players to the point that I had to make a guide on how to do charge inputs when Strife came out for people who are new to Guilty Gear. The input itself is simple. You hold down for a little bit and you press up and a button and you'll get your reversal. Now the emphasis here is certainly on holding down. For a traditional Shoryuken, you have to do forward, down, and down forward. So specific inputs. So something like this. Depending on the game, you might not be able to hold forward the whole time and then do the input. And it's not like you want to hold forward even in games where you can do it, because you're holding forward, you're not blocking, you're just walking into your opponent. The nice thing about the Flash Kick is you are sitting in a relatively safe position. You're holding down back, you're smaller than normal. Yes, you're vulnerable to jump ins, but you're using it as both an anti-air and a reversal. So because you could just sit here, and especially in games where you can't hold forward into DP, if you can just hold down back, you have way more time to react by just tapping up and a button. This makes it much, much, much easier to react to situations, especially since you don't have to move your controller a lot. You just have to switch to one input and press the button. In addition, because of the input, it's very difficult to mess with someone's input. So usually, one way you can mess with people's Shoryuken input is by going over them kind of ambiguously. So if I time my Shoryuken input for specifically when he goes over me, like when I think he's going to attack, when he goes over me here, I'm going to miss and put my stick down instead. Because I don't have a special move that way. I would have to input the Shoryuken the other way. However, Flash Kicks do not have this problem. Finally, usually characters that have a Flash Kick like this also have a projectile tied to a charge input as well. Fighting games usually consider this down back to be down and back, so you're able to use projectiles and the Flash Kick depending on the situation, all from the same input, and you can react very, very quickly. It's pretty powerful and a very flexible set of moves to have. The weakness here though comes from you needing to charge, so you can't get the Flash Kick input without holding down or down back for a certain amount of time. If I tap down back and hit up, I will never get it. I must wait a little bit and then do it. So that means if you have a way to force your opponent to stand up, then they will not be able to reversal. So in this simple example, if I block this jump in, I will not ever be able to respond with a Flash Kick because I am forced to stand up. It gets rid of my charge, thus removing the threat of the input. This tactic is pretty important in games where the offense is more powerful. So then we have the down-down Shoryuken. So this one's pretty flexible, and if you see it, you are just thinking, man, isn't this just the same as a Flash Kick? So you're kind of right. This is kind of a compromise between the Flash Kick and the traditional Shoryuken. So the input makes it so that you can't really get crossed up by it, where no matter what side, I just do it with down-down. But then the fact that you can just tap down-down makes it so that there's not really a restriction on it. Remember that the Flash Kick, you need to hold down for a little bit and then press up so that you can do your reversal. So it being down down means you can do it at any time, like a traditional Shoryuken. This makes it certainly a strong type of Shoryuken to deal with. However, there are a couple of small minor weaknesses to this. So one is that usually down down reversals share a similar movement to Flash Kicks, where you could say that all Shoryukens kind of do this, where they go kind of rising up and forward. Where you go really flying that way, there's usually not like a hitbox behind them. So this type of situation happens where you can make the reversal whiff by quite a bit. Another one comes from the input itself. So if you recall, you could hold down back and then press up to do a Flash Kick. Even the Shoryuken has different ways you can input it, right? I mentioned before, you could do forward, down, down, forward, forward, and you'll still get a Shoryuken. Usually in games that have down, down inputs, they won't give you down-down reversals unless you do the input correctly. So this is down-four, doesn't give it to me. Down-back, doesn't give it to me. The game only gives me her reversal if I tap down-down properly. So this means that you still have to commit. You can't easily do it from a defensive position. You do have to let go of block in order to do it. And last but not least, we have the button DP. So the name sounds a little bit weird, as all special move inputs tend to end with buttons in order to activate them. But when I say button DP, what I mean is the entire input is just buttons. I'm on Persona 4 Arena. This is a pretty extreme example where every single character in the game has one. It's a universal, I believe in English is Furious Action, where you press the B and D button and you'll get a reversal unique to your character. However, there are examples outside of Persona 4, like in Guilty Gear Xrd, Jacko has an invincible reversal on her 2D, one that activates with or without meter. I also usually include easy input reversals here, such as Grand Blue Fantasy with the special move button and DNF Duel as well. So the main strength itself is in the input. So similarly to a flash kick, you can easily react to situations just by pressing the button. You can even go so far as mashing the button in a block stun and just it coming out on the first frame. This was the really, really big complaint about the reversals in this game when Persona 4 Arena originally released. In theory, this is basically the strongest type of meterless reversal that you can have. In my experience, it's usually either given to everybody, like the examples I gave before, Persona 4 Arena, everyone has one, in Grand Blue Fantasy Versus, any character that has an invincible reversal also has the ability to do it with a simpler input. I believe almost every character in DNF Duel also has an invincible reversal meterless as well. Or in the case that not all characters have them, they have some type of major flaw. So Jacko's 2D, shown here, does not have much horizontal range, and it's slower to start up when she does not have meter. So there you have it, the Shoryuken. An iconic move for sure. A lot of people have good memories of like exciting tournament matches or maybe just messing around with their friends with a move like this. It has a pretty simple application in basically all fighting games. It's an invincible move, can be used as an anti-air, that's high risk but also high return. As the genre grew, not only did people create new types of Shoryukens, but also ways to make them safe with resources, introducing new guessing games between the players into the mix. Out of the attack types I thought the Shoryuken was the most straightforward, so I wanted to start here. As usual, if you guys have any questions or comments, definitely feel free to leave them in the comment section below. Like and subscribe if you guys feel like it, and I'll see y'all next time. Peace out.